What is up, YouTube? It's your boy, you know the voice, back at it again with another video. I'm almost done with yesterday's video. I'm gonna be dropping that today, which is the 7th of February, Super Bowl Sunday. I don't know how the fuck we have a Super Bowl right now, considering everything that happened this past year. Pretty simple day today. It's cold as shit. On my way to the store. I got some stuff in the mail from Amazon for my little moto vlog journey. I did get this fucking bike that I've got good reviews on, heard of a lot of good stuff about it. Doesn't fucking work. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. I don't know if it's just a plug and play type of thing. I'm gonna have to mess with the GoPro. I'll mess with it. I'll figure it out. I'll drop another video. I'll be doing that. For the most part today, just gotta run some errands. So I ordered a bunch of stuff off Amazon. I swear I never went hard buying all types of motorcycles. I bought parts for my Harley, for my KTM, for the Grom. What I got today though was this mic that I can't seem to fucking manage to work. Like, I wanted to record this video with that mic to kind of give it, like, so you guys can see like how it works and whatnot. I got that and the Grom chain. My chain fucked up on my Grom. I bought a new link for it, and I guess, like, just over stress and time, it just, like, the ends of the chain might have, like, not warped, but, like, maybe, like, just bent. Or just, I don't know. It's just all messed up. I ordered a new chain. Might go put it on today. Might just go hang out in my storage. Who knows? Gonna go do that. Throw that chain on. Wait till tomorrow. For the sake of the video, I'm gonna take the streets because I did plan on having this microphone and being able to use it on the expressway, which it gets a lot louder inside my van. Super excited about getting all these Grom parts. I am gonna be doing the work on my Grom myself instead of just wasting fucking money and time dealing with a bunch of mechanics who, like, don't fucking give a fuck. I'm just gonna do the work myself. It shouldn't be that hard. The first thing I'm gonna do is this chain, obviously, and after that is the fork seals, which don't seem too bad. I did watch a couple videos on YouTube. It doesn't seem too bad at all. Man, where would we be without YouTube? Man, that shit's funny. After that, I got my KTM. I gotta do some oil changes on those. I am gonna take it to Power Sports and Hammond just to swap the tires out back in the fall when spring comes. But for right now, I'm leaving my dirt tires on there. Might sticker bomb I don't even know what I'm doing with my KTM. I'm just gonna keep it as is, ride it out. I do got Pro Taper bars on there. That's about it, man. I fucking love that bike. That bike is the shit. Man, I've been to the bottom of these dirt bikes, and let me tell you, man, it feels nice having been able to just push start that thing out. But right now, we're on our way to go pick up Ricky. Shoot the other part of this little vlog. But other than that, I did want to talk about what we do, where we're from, and why we're doing this. So we're just a bunch of kids from Chicago who want to ride bikes. Like, I don't even know how else to put it. Like, I came up from nowhere, from the bottom. I had to grind it out. Finally got some money to get a dirt bike. Last summer, I bought a 2009 CRF 450. That thing was the shit. I definitely popped my cherry on that dirt bike. Money. on a bike to just throw away on a bike, I had like $2,000. I found the CRF 09 on Facebook Marketplace off this guy. He wanted $2,200, I believe. And I ended up, and this is like, it's so funny how it works. This, I ended up giving him like $1,900. He did the seals, the fork seals on the dirt bike so that I can just have it and be ready to go. So I bought it for like $1,900. I ended up selling it for $2,500. Came up a little bit. After that, I ended up buying another CRF. I lied. After the CRF, I took that money. I shout out my boy Tom. I forgot. Damn, man, I'm a fucking dick. I forgot dude's name. I bought it off. I think his name was Paul. I want to say his uncle's name was Andy, who was there when I bought the bike. But shout out to my boy Tom. Shout out to that dude who sold me the bike. I ended up buying an 09 Sportster 883 Custom with like 10,000 miles on it. And I bought from Chicago, Southside Chicago. I bought it in St. John, Indiana. So just to give you guys some perspective, I hopped in an Uber. Mind you, this was, man, I don't even remember. It was like, I want to say August or July, maybe even June. I have no clue. But I went, took an Uber to St. John, Indiana to pick up this bike. Mind you, I don't have like Harley gear. I'm not part of that crew. I didn't have nothing to wear. I pulled up in like some Adidas tear-offs, some Nike shoes, a 773 t-shirt, and like my book bag and a hat, glasses, all that crazy stuff. And it's so funny when I bought it, man, because like you couldn't tell me last year, you could not tell me last year that I was gonna own a Harley, because I would not believe it. I've had three sport bikes thus far. I say two because one of them was crashed. I ended up buying it off a buddy that was crashed, and he just needed the money. It was kind of like a pawn, but I ended up selling it. He fell off or whatever, and I ended up selling it. But you couldn't tell me that I was gonna own a Harley, because I'd be like, no, like I'm gonna have a sport bike. That's all I want. And like, it's funny because like last year I ended up buying the dirt bike. I ended up buying the Harley. It's just funny how shit works. It's crazy how shit works. And just, you got it, man. That's just a sign, not a sign, but just always keep your mind open. Always keep your mind open to different shit, because this world's huge. This world's got a lot of stuff in it, and you just gotta, man, just gotta be appreciative of all the shit, man. All the stuff going on and all the people around you. But I ended up buying that Harley. I went out there to St. John, took an Uber, picked it up, and when I got out, the guy had the bike in the driveway already. I can see it. Man, this thing was beautiful. It's clean. I'll show you guys some pics. I remember getting out the car, and he was just looking at me like, you're going to buy the Harley? Like, are you sure you know what you're doing, bud? Man, that was the first time I rode a Harley, and that thing was heavy as hell. Transitioning from a fucking CRF dirt bike, which is the most, like, limber bike. I don't even think I said it right. Like, it's just so small, and it's just so much lighter. Just everything about it. It's just, I don't know. Like, I maybe it was something new. Maybe I liked something new at that time, but I fell in love with it. I went around the block. He lived in
a sandwich.
It's like developments or whatever you call them. Not a gated community. Just a sec, like a, I don't know.
Iridocyclitis.
A very clean, big, open neighborhood. So while he's doing all the paperwork for the Harley, I'm like riding around this area, just fucking zooming around every block, revving it, and I'm just like, man, I'm taking this bike. I don't care. I'm taking it. He gave me the rundown of it. Didn't even know how to turn it on, which was crazy. The keyhole was like on the stem or the fork somewhere, like down there. And then I was just like, I didn't know. It was just something new for me. I loved it. I ended up keeping it. I was gonna sell it. Some of my buddies were gonna buy it to try to flip it, and I mean, I could have flipped it. I only paid like don't know if this will come back and bite me in the ass, but I did pay $2,700 for it. I only had 10,000 miles on it, and it was clean. The front windshield, the whatever you call it, the windshield was like all scratched up. I ended up taking it off, and I rode that thing all summer. That bike was definitely like something new for me. I loved it. I fell in love with it. I don't plan on selling it anymore. The goal is to keep all my bikes now and not have to sell shit like a broke ass nigga. But I definitely want to stunt it out. Man, I fucking love that thing. St. John, Indiana. I went straight downtown Chicago.
Handle from inside the car.
I reached in, grabbed the handle, and the lady like just like yelled. She was like, "Oh my god!" And I'm just like, "What the fuck? Like, you guys just hit me! Like, stop!" And dude, like, it was so crazy how it happened. I was still holding onto the bike and the car at the same time, and it's like, I don't even know how to explain it. It was like the car hit me, but since we weren't going so fast, I was able to like just go with my bike however it was going. It just like wobbled away, and I ended up holding on to my bike, and I didn't fall, and I was like just like tank slapping everywhere, but I made it to the side of the road, and we ended up getting off on Roosevelt Road, Chicago. We exchanged information, and that was just crazy how I ended up getting into that little accident. And to top it all off, the sheriff was taking so long to come and get a report that I ended up leaving. I ended up leaving the scene. And oh my God, I forgot to tell you guys, I never registered that bike. I got into that accident. I didn't have no license plate. I had the title in my book bag and a folder. No insurance. And the guy was from Minnesota. He was like on business or something. And luckily he had insurance. Yeah, I mean that might have been like very, very, very irresponsible and stupid. But I mean, I'm not even gonna say we all make mistakes, because I willingly like didn't give a fuck. But learn from my mistakes. Learn from my mistakes is all I'm gonna say. Learn from my mistakes. No one's teaching me how to do anything. No one's telling me what to do. I'm doing everything on my own. All the shit I get in, I get out of it on my own. I just do for myself. And come along for the journey. Learn some shit from me. But, and I left. I ended up leaving. I went towards Gurnee, Illinois. I knocked that job out, rode back. And that was it. After that, I obviously called the lawyer. And I told the lawyer, like, look, man, I got into this bike accident. I didn't have any of my shit registered and whatnot. And this is like, I don't know, man, but lawyers didn't want to represent me unless I was injured. I wasn't injured. I had a bruise on my arm. I was sore from like the leg down, but like that was it. Like that was literally it. The left side, left arm was bruised. My leg was sore. That was a dent on that car, but like my bike was just had a few scratches and whatnot. And lawyers wouldn't represent me because I just went to the first appointment, the first x-ray, and that was it. The lawyers kept wanting me to pursue like some type of injury and whatnot, and I'm just like, yeah, like I'm good. Like the only thing here is like the loss of time, I guess, of me having to deal with all this physical therapy and whatnot. And they're like, oh yeah, we can include that in the compensation and whatnot. And I'm just like nah, like I just wanted a lawyer to come in and go against the insurance company and get me my damages for my bike and a little something extra. Like I don't even think that was wrong in the first place. Like it wasn't my fault. The cars merged into me. Only thing I didn't do was just, I didn't have insurance or registered at all. Like, that was it. The insurance company ended up, like, we ended up settling because I didn't have a lawyer. And mind you, I didn't have a lawyer. It's like I'm fucked regardless, because I didn't have a lawyer because lawyers don't want to represent a nigga that wasn't injured. I didn't have no injuries. And that was the only way I was going to get the most money. So at the end of the day, I just told the insurance company, like, just pay me my bike, give me the damages for my bike, and that was it. And they ended up like giving me an offer of like 50% off, no, 50% of all the damages plus $300. And I mean, I sat on it for like a month. I was like, dude, like there's no way. Like if anybody else were to get into that accident, they would definitely crash. They would definitely hit the ground. But I guess the lesson here is if you get into an accident, act hurt. I am a business owner. I don't have time to be going and faking an injury, going to physical therapy, taking time out of work and whatnot. Like, no, like you hit me, you damaged my bike. Now, just pay the damages in the bike. So, long story short, we ended up selling for 50%. I had to take my Harley to Harley Davidson in Wrigleyville. They gave me like a $3,900 quote for everything. And the insurance gave me half of that, which is, I mean, it was like $2,200, but whatever. Learn from my mistakes. Register your bike if you got a title. Go get insurance. It ain't that much. I think insurance was like $18 a month. It ain't shit at all to have like coverage on a bike. And because you never know what the fuck is gonna happen.
Whoa. Look at this dude. First car moving.
Bro, you got some good wheelies.
We just finished unloading some scooters. Unfortunately, we had some technical difficulties. We're dealing with that, but we decided to play with this. What we got here, Chris?
A motherfucking bike.
A bike.
KTM.
Let's get it on. We don't give a what, what. We don't give a what, what. Get it on the floor. 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 You don't wanna party, then your ass gotta go. You don't wanna party, then your ass gotta go. You can ride that's on the floor. Bounce that's on the floor. Freak that's on the floor. Let's get it on.
Wheelies on my shit, but when I want to learn wheelies, nobody let me ride their shit. It's scary, bro. Every time he gets it up, it's like,
Look at this dude. Wait till he's...
what you're doing. I can't wait to put my street tires on it. Let's go, bring it in. Alright, let's take it in, man. Huh?
First call moving.com.
Keys, right? It's in gear. Half click up. Wrapping up, go home. I'm gonna take this for when I get my GoPro mic. I don't have to come back and get it.
Why are you taking the helmet?
For when I get my GoPro stuff.
I think I love you.